Hello, and welcome to this Archer Point presentation on changing and customizing fields in Business Central. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at Archer Point, and I'm going to be leading you through this demonstration today. The first thing that we want to look at is how we can customize our main role center area. We go up here in the upper right to settings and say personalize. That's how we're going to make all the changes that we see today. So you'll notice that there's several areas. We have our headline area, our navigation bar, as well as what are called our wide queues, and then our action queues or our tiles. So on all of these areas that we see, we have the ability to either click and drag if we want to move where something is in a certain order, or when you hover over a segment and you see this red arrow, we can click on that, and then we can have the ability to either select move or we can remove that. So this is what allows us to add and remove areas from our main role center area. And we can see here, there's things like current parts that are hidden. So we have the ability to click and show those. And when we're in personalized, we can see those hidden areas. So everything else is pretty self-explanatory. We can go ahead and say done for here. And on our navigation bar, one of the things that you'll notice is these are all coming from bookmarks. So if I click here on items, I see here over on the right-hand side that this was bookmarked. And if I uncheck that, then it's no longer in my navigation bar. And when I go to search and I type in items, we see that as I'm highlighting the line, I have the ability to quickly add and remove bookmarks from my search pane as well. So if there's multiple things that you want to quickly add to that, you don't even have to navigate into the screen to get them added. It's pretty convenient. So next, let's go and look at our lists. So when I am here and I'm looking at my items, I'm going to go to the details area of my fact box pane for this next part. And we're going to go to settings and personalize again. So here you'll see that we have the ability to add and remove as well as move the fields, not only in the list, but I can do this in my fact box area. So if there's areas here that are more or less relevant, for example, right now this warehousing area is hidden, you can add and remove all of the different tabs, and you can move and remove. Again, clicking on the red arrow, I can say remove. I don't want to see my safety stock quantity. And that's how we can change it in our fact box. And then in our regular area, we can click and drag to set where these are going. And again, if we want to remove something, we just click the red arrow. We have an additional area when we're looking at a list view. So for example, if I want to set my freeze pane here, I can now do that. So as I scroll through, I can see both my item and my description. And if we want to remove the freeze pane, then I just click back on that and I say clear freeze pane. And so that's how we can move things around when we're looking at a list view. And additionally here, if I want to add a field, I can click the plus field button in the upper left, and then I can see everything that's available to me. There's also a search function here so that I can search for what I'm looking for so that you don't have to scroll through and find it from the whole list. Let's go ahead and say done here. And then we're going to jump in and look at what it is for a card. So a card is when you're selecting a single record. And so now I'm looking at my item card. And so there's a couple different ways that we can change how we're seeing information here. And so we're going to go to settings and personalize. So again, we can click and drag information. So if I want to see quantity on hand up here, I can just click and drag that here. And on my card, anytime I have a collapsible tab, like what we have here, so not only can I remove it, as we can with everything else, but we can also determine what the priority is for how that shows. So if we want to hide it, if we want to lower the priority, we put it under Show More, because there's fields hidden underneath here. And if we want to elevate the priority to say always show, then we can make sure that that's always shown. And the other option that we have here is show when collapsed. So that means that when if I go ahead and add that, and I say I want to see this when it's collapsed, that means that when my tab is collapsed, I have a quick view so that I don't have to expand the whole tab or look at all of those fields. So we've got three different levels of priority there with when it's on a collapsed tab, when it's showing regularly, and then when it's hidden under Show More. So we can go ahead and set our priorities, move our fields around as we need. And then the next thing is, how do we do that for our navigation pane up here? So if I have an area that I use a lot, we can not only, you know, move these main areas, but I can also dive into those and say, let's look at our units of measure. And if I'm always using my units of measure, I can just click and drag that out. And now I can put those that I always use into the main navigation bar, or I can drop it into another area. So if I want to see units of measure under just item, now I can click and move that into a relevant dropdown that's easier to access. So those can be placed either directly or they can be nested into another area on the navigation tab. And, you know, just as a reminder, when you're designing these for groups, commonly this is set up for when your admin is designing screens for users, either for a new implementation or for as users start using the system more, you can create these roles, move things around, personalize it exactly how it needs to be, and then deploy how this looks to a group of users. You have the ability to take permission away from being able to modify and personalize. So what we see a lot with some groups that only need limited access to things and they don't want them to be able to click around and maybe see everything is an administrator or someone in the IT area will create these screens and then hide the areas that they don't want users to see. And then they remove permissions for those users to be able to do the personalization so that there's no way that the user can go back in and add those things in. And so in addition to security, they also don't even see that it exists. And the last thing that we're going to cover really quick is our form. So if we look at, for example, a sales order. So forms are just combinations of cards and lines, tables in the different sections. So for example, this general area functions as a card. So everything that we just looked at, if we personalize this here, everything that we looked at before, I can move things around here. I can move things from other cards. So if I want to grab invoice details below and move that up into another area, I can do that. And same with what we saw earlier with our tables, we can set and clear our freeze panes and click and drag our fields so that they're in the order that we want to see them in. So everything here is the same. We can, you know, click, move, modify, hide, show, and it's just about, you know, having a combination of those two functions here. So that should be everything that we've covered today. Hopefully this has been helpful. If you have any additional questions about how to design the roles or doing modifications, please feel free to leave a comment or reach out to Archer Point directly, and we'll do our best we can to help you.
Thank you for watching this Archer Point video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.